the human brain is the most complex organ, the most complex computational system that we know of. And the goal of our team is to bring together novel ideas in order to do two things that are really critical when something goes wrong, such as a brain injury or a brain disorder. What we want to do is we want to be able to see what's going on inside the brain and to be able to affect it, to diagnose what's gone wrong and to be able to create treatments. We want to be able to sense the brain at a high resolution, and you want to be able to stimulate the neurons again at a high resolution.
So one of the most important challenges of existing non-invasive methods to interface with the brain is the dispersion of waves within the brain tissue, especially as they pass through layers that protect the brain tissue. They get dispersed and scattered. If you use optical, ultrasonic, or magnetic signals, they get scattered and you cannot reach deep regions of the brain and achieve the required resolution. In this project, we are aiming to tackle this problem by counterbalancing the dispersive effects of the brain tissue and the layers that protect the brain tissue.
What really excites me about this project is that we're trying to achieve much higher resolution, which will ultimately help identify regions in the brain that are impacted by disease with a much higher resolution than previously possible.
We were very happy to receive a large grant from DARPA to support this. These are ideas which, while we have validated them to some degrees over the last 3 years in computational models, in theory, and sometimes a little bit in practice as well, this funding really pushes this grant forward, brings researchers together in order to make things happen that would have otherwise taken decades to happen. What is novel here, and what is the challenge that our team has taken up, is that we want to do all of this non-invasively.
So in this project, we are going to use non-invasive ultrasonic waves from outside the brain in order to sculpt a virtual lens within the brain tissue itself. When we send optical signals from the surface of the brain, we can probe the local neuronal activity in the brain when we look at the reflected signal from the brain tissue. So without doing any surgery or opening the brain, we are basically embedding a virtual lens within the brain tissue, and this way we can funnel and focus light to reach deep into the brain tissue without losing resolution. The interesting aspect of this project is that by changing the ultrasonic waves from outside, we can move around that sculpted virtual lens, and basically we can target different locations within the brain tissue. This technique can revolutionize existing imaging techniques, but in this project, we are using it for recording and functional imaging of the neural activity within the brain tissue.
The overarching goal is to combine neurosensing and neurostimulation. And so my contribution to the project is really dominantly focused on the neurosensing aspect. So my background is optical imaging, in particular using near-infrared light, do non-invasive sensing of brain function. And so the inherent problem with using near-infrared light to sense brain function is that optical imaging is very much limited in terms of resolution and how well we can resolve the brain and the structures inside the brain or functional activation inside the brain. What we're trying to do within this project is to actually overcome some of those limitations. And so in collaboration with Professor Chamansar, we're using ultrasound to focus light deeper inside the tissue and then use interaction of near-infrared light with the brain to sense vascular changes in the brain as well as neuronal activation in the brain, all non-invasively using near-infrared light.
In order to treat many neurological disorders today, such as epilepsy and Parkinson's, surgeons commonly implant devices into your brain and stimulate it in a very precise manner. What we are trying to do, the challenge in this project, is to do the stimulation non-invasively. To do so, we are injecting tiny amounts of current into the head, non-invasively from multiple electrodes on the scalp. The key novelty that we bring into this approach is that we are able to harness non-linear dynamics of neurons, which are extremely complicated to understand. We are able to harness them to do high spatiotemporal precision neurostimulation, as is required to treat these multiple disorders.
We are designing an array of electrodes in the form of a wearable patch that can be placed over the scalp that generates spatiotemporal electrical signals that when they propagate through the brain tissue, they can trigger neuronal activity. We are leveraging the physics of electrical signal propagation through the brain tissue, coupled with the dynamics of neural activity in order to enable this non-invasive stimulation modality. So using this novel neural interface for non-invasive stimulation of brain activity, we can study how the brain functions, and also we can design novel therapeutic interventions all non-invasively without having to open the skull or do any kind of surgery.
So my role in the project is to take all of those technologies and be able to bring them together into a size, into a form factor that's going to be suitable to be put on a person's head. That's going to be lightweight, it's going to be comfortable. That is a huge engineering, technological research effort that overlays all of the other cool science work that's going to be going on in the project.
But neuroengineering is a very important research area in biomedical engineering, involving also very important electric computer engineering and neuroscience as well. So we have three extremely bright young faculty co-lead this major research effort in collaboration with other partners and to tackle this grand challenge. And these three young faculty really led this major research program come up with a absolutely revolutionary ideas. And if it's going to be successful, it's not going to make Carnegie Mellon to be one of the another major groundbreaking achievement in the world. Most importantly, it's going to change how neuroscience research is going to be done, change what clinical medicine would be practiced. I'm extremely excited and really very proud about these bright young faculty taking this lead and also honored to be part of this major DARPA program.
It's just wonderful that CMU has the resources for such interdisciplinary research. Otherwise, this project would not be possible.